In my previous video, we provided refutation of the doctrine of God the Mother, espoused by the World Mission Society Church of God. In this second video, we will examine another of the peculiar doctrines of this group, that the second coming of Christ was fulfilled in the life of a Korean man named Ahn Sahng Hong. As with the first video, this group has a reputation for attempting to copyright claim anyone who offers criticism of their teachings based on their own materials, even though this falls under fair use law. To save myself the headache and to preserve the life of this video and the rest in this short series, I won't be using any screenshots or video clips from the World Mission Society's website or social media outlets. I will provide links to the respective pages in the description below. Ahn Sahng Hong was born in 1918 to a Buddhist family, but later converted to Seventh-Day Adventism in the 1950s. He was excommunicated from the Seventh-Day Adventists in 1962 because of his controversial teachings. In the wake of his excommunication, Ahn Sahng Hong established his own church, the Witnesses of Jesus Church of God, in 1964. Ahn Sahng Hong was married and fathered 4 children during his life. Of note for this video is that he died in 1985. In the wake of his death, his congregation split into 2 groups, the first being led by his son and the second being led by a man named Joo Chil Kim and Zhang Gil Ja, the woman believed to be the incarnation of God the Mother. This second group would be the one which we now know as the World Mission Society Church of God. On their website page titled Christ Ahn Sahng Hong, the World Mission Society Church of God claims that, quote, according to the teachings of the Bible, Jesus must come to earth a second time to restore the new covenant that was lost after the apostolic age. Christ Ahn Sahng Hong fulfilled this biblical prophecy by reestablishing all the original teachings of Jesus. He accomplished what the reformers before him could not, and achieved the perfect reformation by restoring the new covenant, making him the last reformer. In 1964, Christ Ahn Sahng Hong, the Second Coming Jesus, established the World Mission Society Church of God as the only church in the world that celebrates the feasts of God. Through various Bible prophecies, you too can confirm the identity of Christ Ahn Sahng Hong. The only scripture that is cited to substantiate this belief is Hebrews chapter 9, verse 28. As we've seen with regards to their doctrine of God the Mother, the World Mission Society has a tendency to cite scripture in a way that is highly ambiguous. This is true also for their doctrine of Christ Ahn Sahng Hong. There is nothing in this verse or in all of Hebrews chapter 9 that describes the return of Christ as a Korean man, a Buddhist, a father of 4 children who would die a second death. The World Mission Society Church of God literally has nothing to stand on here, only their simple assertion that Ahn Sahng Hong is the second coming of Christ. In other words, he is because we said he is. Contrary to the World Mission Society's doctrine, asserting that Ahn Sahng Hong is the second coming of Christ creates a multitude of problems. First, if Ahn Sahng Hong is the returned Christ, this would make Christ a sinner. This is proven in 2 ways. Remember that Ahn Sahng Hong was raised as a Buddhist, which would mean that he spent this portion of his life worshiping a false god, in violation of the 1st and 2nd of the 10 Commandments. Second, Ahn Sahng Hong was married with children. If he was the returned Christ, then this would make Christ guilty of the same sin as the sons of God of Genesis chapter 6, verse 2, who, quote, took wives for themselves, whomever they chose. Quote, God did not spare the angels when they sinned, but cast them into Tartarus and committed them to pits of darkness reserved for judgment. And angels who did not keep their own domain, but abandoned their proper abode, he has kept in eternal bonds under darkness for the judgment of the great day. The Bible teaches that it is not for spiritual beings to engage in fleshly intimacy. This is why Jesus never got married during his first coming, because it would have been a violation of the created order. Likewise, This is why he will not partake in marriage in his second coming. If Ahn Sahng Hong is the second coming of Christ, then Christ is a sinner, and his atoning work counts for nothing. Second, Christ is not subject to a second death. The same book of Hebrews that the World Mission Society cites to support Ahn Sahng Hong as the returned Christ is replete with the fact that Christ will not die again. The Apostle Paul echoes this understanding of Christ's eternal life. Christ has sat down at the right hand of God in final victory over death and the grave. He will come again without any reference to death for himself or those who follow him. That Ahn Sahng Hong is dead and buried is proof that he is not the returned Christ. Third, Ahn Sahng Hong is guilty of false prophecy. Documents from the 2005 case of the World Mission Society Church of God versus Ji Wan Tok in the Northern Seoul Regional Court show that Ahn Sahng Hong made a prediction that the world would end in 1988. These documents also show two other failed prophecies in 1999 and 2012. These failed predictions make Ahn Sahng Hong a false prophet. Regarding false prophets, the Bible says, "You may say in your heart, how will we know the word which the Lord has not spoken?" When a prophet speaks in the name of the Lord, if the thing does not come about or come true, that is the thing which the Lord has not spoken. The prophet has spoken it presumptuously. You shall not be afraid of him. If a prophet or a dreamer of dreams arises among you and gives you a sign or a wonder, and the sign or the wonder comes true, concerning which he spoke to you, saying, "Let us go after other gods, whom you have not known, and let us serve them," you shall not listen to the words of that prophet or that dreamer of dreams. For the Lord your God is testing you to find out if you love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul. You shall follow the Lord your God and fear him. You shall keep his commandments, listen to his voice, serve him, and cling to him. But that prophet or that dreamer of dreams shall be put to death, because he has counseled rebellion against the Lord your God, who brought you from the land of Egypt and redeemed you from the house of slavery, to seduce you from the way in which the Lord your God commanded you to walk. So you shall purge the evil from among you. Jesus never gave a false prophecy. In fact, he warned us about those false prophets who would come in the future. This leads to our fourth point. When Christ returns, it will be known by everyone. As the lightning comes from the east and flashes even to the west, so will the coming of the Son of Man be. But when the Son of Man comes in his glory and all the angels with him, then he will sit on his glorious throne. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate them one from another, as the shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. And he will put the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. And after he had said these things, he was lifted up while they were looking on, and a cloud received him out of their sight. And as they were gazing intently into the sky while he was going, behold, two men in white clothing stood beside them. They also said, "Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking into the sky? This Jesus who has been taken from you into heaven will come in just the same way as you have watched him go into heaven. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive and remain will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so we shall always be with the Lord. Behold, he is coming with the clouds, and every eye will see him, even those who pierced him, and all the tribes of the earth will mourn over him. So it is to be. Amen." Wherever you land in your end times theology, it is safe to say that none of these things happened in 1918 when Ahn Sahng Hong was born or at any point during his lifetime. If he really was the second coming of Christ, every knee would have bowed to him as Lord. that the majority of people did not and have not proves he was not Christ. Lastly, Ahn Sahng Hong did not even believe or teach that he was Christ. As documented on his own tombstone, Ahn Sahng Hong taught his followers that he was the prophet Elijah, not Christ. Of course, the things that prove he was not Christ prove he wasn't Elijah either. This belief that Ahn Sahng Hong was Christ was perpetuated by Joo Chil Kim. But if this were true, it would mean that Christ was ignorant of who he was. The biblical testimony tells us otherwise. Now his parents went to Jerusalem every year at the feast of the Passover. And when he became 12, they went up there according to the custom of the feast. And as they were returning, after spending the full number of days, the boy Jesus stayed behind in Jerusalem. But his parents were unaware of it, but supposed him to be in the caravan, and went a day's journey. And they began looking for him among their relatives and acquaintances. When they did not find him, they returned to Jerusalem looking for him. Then, after 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of the teachers, both listening to them and asking them questions. And all who heard him were amazed at his understanding and his answers. When they saw him, they were astonished. And his mother said to him, "Son, why have you treated us this way? Behold, your father and I have been anxiously looking for you." And he said to them, "Why is it that you are looking for me? Did you not know that I had to be in my father's house?" But they did not understand the statement which he had made to them. Even as a child, Jesus was well aware of who he was. If Ahn Sahng Hong didn't know that he was Christ when he actually was, then this means that he is not omniscient, all-knowing, one of God's fundamental attributes. That Ahn Sahng Hong didn't have a clue about being Christ is further proof that he was not. This is not the only area where Ahn Sahng Hong taught his followers something different from what the World Mission Society teaches its adherents today. The most notable difference is that Ahn Sahng Hong flatly refuted the doctrine of God the Mother, which is so fundamental to modern World Mission Society beliefs. It is plain and evident that, contrary to the World Mission Society Church of God, Ahn Sahng Hong was not the second coming of Christ. He is merely a deceased false prophet, one of many who have come to mislead people away from the true and living Christ. If you are currently a member of the World Mission Society Church of God, please read the Bible for yourself and examine its clear, consistent teaching of who Christ really is.